Yep. Alright, guys, what's up? We back with another attack. The Marat with the Marat. The Talking Shit Podcast.
We gotta take a little intermission. Shit got real. We gotta handle it. But we back now. What up, YouTube and everybody else? It's your boy Rock Steady. 302, I missed y'all. Hope y'all missed us. We got some news for y'all. Not really.
Ain't been enough. A lot of exciting news. We've been getting to this money. And getting some more stuff so we can get some more content for y'all. But it's your boy Kigati Maserati, Body Bag Entertainment, Five Finger Gang. You know what it is.
We're gonna try working a video podcast for y'all one day. I noticed that we were gonna do that. We haven't got around to that yet.
Yeah, we gotta get some proper lighting for that. I got the camera on my computer, which is probably not even a good camera. We just gonna have that shit in the top corner with some gameplay or something in the background. I was hoping for it to be episode 10. I think we're on like episode 7 right now. We can still do that. We just gotta get it prepared. New podcast day is Saturday. And disclaimer. It's the ideas of Kigati Maserati and Rocksteady, the individuals, and not Body Bag Entertainment as a company. But if you look at my Twitter, you might think otherwise because I run the Twitter. My ideas should be meant for my personal Twitter.
That is correct, Mundo. Ooh. But
how you feel about these pro-black feminists?
Feminists that hate men.
Pro-black feminists.
Pro-black feminists.
Feminists that hate men, but only when it's towards black women. And only care about the pro-black if it's for women.
Double standards. The way you just explained it, I'm like, that's two-sided from exactly. The get-go.
They pro-black for the black people, for the black women. But they feminists, but only for black women.
Can't do that. You got it's either full fledged.
They exist. I'm telling you.
It's either full. That was standard. It's 100%. But that borderline. If you're gonna be a feminist, if you're gonna rock out in that category, you gotta be 100. You can't half step a feminist. Cause y'all swear to God, y'all know everything.
It'd be white feminists that are racist, and black feminists that are racist. I know black people can't be racist towards white people, but you can be racist towards Hispanics. Asians, just about all of the above.
But y'all need to chill out with that shit. Full fledged or not at all. Well, don't half ass shit. Be a bunch of shit. Nope. But me and KG's, we. I don't know if you want to talk about anything else about that, but I don't really care too much about that, you double standard bastards.
We're getting these sports. The NBA preseason started. Football is well on its way into the season.
Yeah, you got some underdogs there in the football category. But I just want to talk about the basketball very quick, because I know everybody has been praying and waiting to see what LeBron and the Lakers can do. Have you watched any of those games or catch any highlights?
I seen some highlights. It was looking kind of like preseason-ish. Like, it was just...
Of course.
Like, they played in, like the scrimmages and shit and practice. That's what it looked like. Or that's what they did, most likely. Mm-hmm. But, like, against another team that got a whole different gameplay as you, and got a whole different mindset. Like, y'all didn't practice every scenario. It's gonna be a scenario y'all come across that's gonna be different. Yeah. And I mean, like, the people they got is gonna make it, they're gonna get easy wins because the people they got. But the chemistry, like, I don't see them working together. I gotta wait till the full season start because it's only preseason. Most people just come into preseason there. You feel me? Most people won't even be in the regular season.
This is all baby steps. And they is the Lakers, they're really a new team, man. Like, that's a whole brand new team. It's a full of well-known folks coming together, y'all get that chemistry going.
And most people they playing with, or most rosters, like the lineup they playing with, probably wouldn't even be the lineup for the preseason.
Exactly.
Boston, they had Gordon Hayward, Al Horford, Jason Tatum, Jaylen Brown and Kyrie Irving starting. But I'm pretty sure that's not going to be the lineup in, when the season starts.
Of course not.
They got that one big dude, Boston. He a rookie. He be getting up there. He got a little bit of bounce. He just need to get a little bit more accustomed to the game.
He got nice speed, or was you watching him that much?
Oh, I didn't watch him that much.
Like I said, it is preseason. Just like football, we wasn't paying too much to it, but the regular season start, it's there, isn't it? But basketball's going. I think this year is going to be nice for basketball season.
Hopefully,
we got some new, rookies to look at. A few rookies actually, like the dude Dante,
and a few sophomores.
Too, but
you gotta think about it. Rookies, everybody wanna see the rookies, see how they get accustomed to like the NBA from college. But the sophomores, those are the ones that most people, like the analysts will have their eyes on. Cause like people like Jason Tatum, he had the spotlight on him since the middle of last season. So they gonna be looking for him to step into that spotlight that they were shining on. Yeah. Jaylen Brown and Terry Rozier. And if they can't do that, they're going to get fucking thrashed by the media.
That is true. Unfortunately, they did take that loss to the Cavs.
Yeah, we had skunking them for three quarters and they came back.
I'm sorry, right? I don't like it really matter. Yeah. But y'all were pulling up decent points. Like, I got 32 points in the first quarter.
I say we were skunking them to the third quarter. And
I scored over 25 points each quarter. So, but that fourth quarter, you only scored 18 points. They kind of dogged y'all right there. But hey, shit happens.
Well, I don't really care about them games because I don't want to watch them because I don't want to see nobody get injured because it's going to piss me off for the whole season. So, ankle injury might have you out for 3 months.
So you'd rather find out about it on the news? I don't know. Me personally, I'd rather see it happen and then be like, wait, what happened to my boy? Because sometimes you don't really watch ESPN like that or nothing. So you watch the next game, like, what happened to my boy? Then you'll see on a little, on the side screen.
I get the alerts on my phone from Boston.
Oh, yeah, all right. Mm. But that's the worst, though, because like Gronkowski, he hurt. Big Gronk.
Yeah.
Number one tight end right now. He hurt. So how you think I feel? And I watched the game happen. I'm like, he gets hurt every season now, man. I think he started to become a liability though.
Yeah, he getting too old with his bones and what they used to be.
But he's just about to be a reforming team. But I start taking L's up the ass. Right now we're like 3-2.
It's a lot of reforming teams. Mm-hmm. Or teams that's about to start reforming. It's a new generation. You can see the new generation of people coming. Like this generation, like last year sophomores and the year before, well, last year freshmen and the year before freshmen, like that generation in basketball, they starting a whole new generation. Like you can see like the old shit going out and the new niggas coming in and starting to shine. Like Donovan Mitchell, Jason Tatum, Ben Simmons, Joel Embiid, Lonzo Ball. Like they names are bigger than their game right now.
It's nice to have new people out there too, for real, for real.
Like last year, I mean not last year, but like a couple years ago, you wasn't hearing about it. Like NBA was exciting because the people that been in there, like they wasn't paying attention to new niggas.
They
like,
never paid attention.
From 2010 to motherfucking 2014, niggas ain't give a fuck about freshmen.
At all. Nowadays, people getting talent. They coming out 6'10" now, and they actually can do both sides of the court, offense and defense, pass, shoot. But now,
and then you think about it, like niggas from that era that I just said. 2010 to 2014, they had good college careers, but when they got to the NBA, they was mediocre. Most of them either got put on the bench as an eighth man and don't even come off the bench during the playoffs. You watch the playoffs, you can see only about five people play. Five or six, like about seven people play depending on how good the seventh person is.
Exactly. But they
with the Cavs, only about six people played. LeBron played damn near every minute, every game.
42 minutes.
And I say six people because he took a 2-minute break where they put him in. Yeah. Who is the nigga name? That's a nigga. He's a rookie last year. It's like Seti Osman, I think his name is.
Never heard of him, Chief.
Because he ain't never get in. But he got in, it was just, you know, the Cavs last year, they was bashing the niggas that was veterans. Not really. They couldn't really look up to the rookies and be like, look, y'all need to do some better shit. They're too busy bashing J.R. Smith for being in the playoffs and only scoring about probably like less than 20 points the whole playoffs. Probably about 20 points, 25. The whole playoffs combined.
It's a name. It's the Kevin Love. It's a name that carries you. Like, people expect you to do good just because of that name.
Kevin Love averaged a double-double, motherfucker. Like, hey, you gonna come back getting 10 and 20, 15 and 20. He had one good game after he came back from that quote-unquote injury. And then that was it.
I don't know. But
like, the NBA season is cool and all. Like, you really, you got, now you can't sleep on the preseason. Because the preseason ultimately amounts up to the postseason. Injuries and rankings and where you're going to be placed, like what seed you're going to be. But once you get to that postseason, nothing matter in the fucking preseason no more. Just can you handle this pressure of X amount of eyes on you every night, every night. Game, taking a loss, having to come back from that loss, winning three games against a team that's just as good as you or better?
Football-wise, week four, it's a lot of underdogs getting these wins. I don't know if you watch football, but the Kansas City Chiefs, they're, I believe they're still undefeated right now, man.
What about the Rams?
The Rams? Todd Gurley, he's running the team right now, so undefeated team.
I had pulled a fast one on Hawk. Mind you, I don't watch football or nothing. Rock and Hawk was talking about football. I'm like, man, y'all just mad because my team undefeated. I don't know, how many teams is it in football?
16, I believe.
16 teams in football. I just threw a rock in the pond. Feel me? He said, oh, now you a Rams fan. First thing in my head was, oh, so Rams is undefeated. Cool. Now I'm a Rams fan.
Have you always been a Rams fan?
Nope. I was a Colts fan.
Colts got their ass whooped by the Patriots.
Yeah. That's why I'm a Colts fan. When y'all was talking about that shit yesterday, that's why I said, yeah, I used to be a Colts fan. Nope, I just said, my team undefeated right now. It's just my whole flow up. Pop gave me a team, so I ain't a bandwagon. I got to sign the team. You feel me?
Like I said, there's some underdogs this year. Patriots, they're 3-2 right now. The Eagles, they're getting their wins, but I don't think they're ever really going to go far because they're barely winning. They just lost their last game. But the underdogs, the Chiefs, they're undefeated right now. The Rams, they're undefeated right now. But they won't really, I don't think they will go far because they really don't have any playoff wins like that. That's the thing. They haven't really got to the playoffs like that. But the underdogs are coming this year, but you guys got a battle with the Seahawks on Sunday. You guys somehow always got trouble with the Seahawks, so that might be your first L coming up.
Guys, I'm joking about me being a Rams fan. I probably still won't even keep over football. But I think it's it is two people. One person died from a football injury. I think one person still has head injuries from playing football. So, I mean, y'all don't want that football rule to take place and no smacking helmets, but if you want your life to be, you want your favorite player to stay alive long enough so you can see him win the chip, you better make sure them rules is in effect. And make sure you use a pillow when you sack the QB. and a blanket.
Oh, man, nah,
and always have a little book in your waistband where y'all keep your towels so y'all can read them a little story before y'all sack.
Just, all right, well, we're gonna move over to a tad bit of baseball, because it's postseason right now for baseball, and
ouch.
I love me some postseason baseball. That's when everybody is in full effect, trying to move on to the World Series, get that World Series championship. You actually, do you even watch baseball? You understand baseball at all, kid?
Nope. I just like seeing people hit home runs.
It's a lot of home runs during the postseason, I'm telling you, man. And it's a good rivalry going on right now, Boston versus Yankees.
That rivalry's been going on forever.
Forever. And mm-hmm. they got a series going on right now. Yankees, I think Boston won like 5-2, I think, something like that. But that's a squad, Boston, right? You like all Boston. So you might as well watch that rivalry. It gets real.
I like the Boston Celtics. Hey. I told you my football team used to be the coach then in Indianapolis.
Hey, man, Boston got a chance to go to the World Series. But I like the postseason, but if you don't got nobody talk about it away, hey, like it, we're gonna move on.
Let's get to this music. It was a lot of music stuff that happened. It wasn't nothing really major that happened. Nobody passed. Some world news, I guess.
I mean,
this would be considered.
Wayne dropped that album, but.
I'm talking about like no fucker. Ain't nobody get beat up or that.
Oh, okay.
Pass away. But world news ish. Bill Cosby was sentenced to 3 to 10 years. I won't get into my ideas on how that's fucked up.
Real fucked up.
But if y'all ain't arresting them priests that was touching little boys, then just don't worry about Bill Cosby.
Or some of these
other shit that happened 60 years
ago. Or some of these other motherfuckers that's just getting probation.
Facts.
But, and this shit is recent, but a nigga, this happened 50 years ago. Can get convicted. Fuck out of here.
Statutes and limitations was all up. They just want him to get booked because
they about to take over NBC.
Exactly.
Yeah, black man,
they have nothing else on him. So they threw all that shit out in the public and made the public sentencing, basically.
And then you got motherfucking teachers out here getting hit the motherfucking students and shit. Get probation. Fuck out of here. You got motherfucking cops. Go on niggas' cribs, shoot motherfuckers, changing their stories, get manslaughter and shit. Fuck out of here. No. Cold-blooded murder, cold-blooded rape and all that shit. Y'all
niggas
getting off.
You got cops in the club taking pictures of bitches' asses and shit.
Fuck out of here with that shit. Y'all pissing me off this justice system. Y'all screwed up.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck that. But, back to the music shit. Lil Wayne dropped the Carter 5. Finally. I can't say finally. He could have been dropped. He just, you feel me? But going through them legal issues. It was highly anticipated. I ain't the biggest Wayne fan. He'd be in my top 15. But not my top 10. It was a cool album. He had a few features on there. Sold almost 500,000, almost 500,000 records. Will end up going platinum, but.
Yeah, I listened to it too. I fuck with a couple songs. I think it was Dedication. I fuck with that. Uproar. I was a good one, Uproar. The beginning. I got hype. The first couple seconds, I started, almost started crip walking and shit. Anyway, and then Mona Lisa, that was one of my other favorites. That was my top three right there for that music.
I didn't really fuck with Mona Lisa, because it sounded like it was trying to make it like a Tony story type of, you feel me? You know, Meek Mill Tony killed his own man child for Holy Brick. But it wasn't like a story. It was just like, it was just telling you, it was trying to make it a story, but it wasn't a story. Script. It was basically just, don't fuck with Lisa, because Lisa is just basically telling you not to fuck with certain girls. It wasn't giving you a story, it was just giving you advice. And using, not saying girls, it was just giving the girl, and then that's why I ain't messing with it. But it was alright. I'm just trying to hear something other than Wayne right now.
I'm trying to hear something.
Little baby, well, I ain't gonna get to that yet. Gunna, nah, damn, see, I might as well get to that. Little baby and Gunna drop their collab album, I think it is. Drip Harder. I fuck with it. They got some good songs on there. I don't know which songs are gonna take off, because I listen to all my songs in the car with like the speaker all the way up. So my phone be up here making a bunch of extra noise. I need some soundproofing in my room. I listen to all my songs in the car with the speaker or with the volume all the way up. And I just listen to the beat, basically. If I fuck with the beat, I let the motherfucking vocals and the lyrics come in second of that. What the fuck was that? But I fuck with the beat, I let the shit come in second of that. All the beats is hot, but, you feel me? Not everybody just gonna fuck with the beat. Niggas is trying to figure out what niggas is saying. But I fuck with that shit. I listened to that shit like 3 or 4 times yesterday. Thug Drop is on the Run EP. I fuck with that shit. I fuck with that shit more than his Lion Language album.
I can't really speak much on that. None of that shit.
They got some good songs. Drip Harder. Off-White V-Long featuring Nav and Dirt. That's alright. Business is Business and Belly. I fuck with those. Deep End. I fuck with that shit heavy. I fuck with World Is Yours heavy. Fuck with Underdog, fuck with I Am. Seals, Pills is cool. My Jeans with Thugger, I fuck with that. Style Stiller, that song cool. Close Friends, that song cool. Drip Too Hard, that was a single that was out. Drip Too Hard, Don't Stand Too Close. You go fucking Run the Drown, trying to ride a nigga away. That shit. And then Never Recover, featuring Drake. I fuck with that song. I fuck with Close Friends, but it's like a slow song. So it's like, that ain't gonna, I mean, people gonna fuck with it, but it ain't gonna be one of them songs that's like, you gonna hear in the club type shit.
Okay.
Young Thug, On the Run. On the Run, the first song, I fuck with. I be blasting that shit in the car, that shit go crazy. I fuck with Icy, that shit go crazy. Climax featuring Black, that's one of them slow songs you ain't gonna hear in the club. Sin featuring Jaden Smith. I had to get adjusted to that song. Since the EP is only 6 songs, I just let that shit play all the way through. I kept hearing that shit, and I fuck with that shit. I fuck with that shit just as much as I fuck with the rest of the shit. Rail in My Veins, that's probably my favorite song going there. And then High, featuring Elton John. That was a single that was dropped. I fuck with it. It's cool, you gotta give it a listen. The EP at least, if you don't listen to Lil Baby and Gunna shit.
You might as well.
It's only 6 songs. Gunna shit, that shit only 13 songs. But Lil Baby and Gunna shit. Kanye West. He went on SNL with Lil Pump. First of all, Lil Pump was supposed to be booked. He was just off of social media. That's what I think he got booked from, social media. It's like NBA Youngboy wasn't allowed to be on social media for however long. I think they did the same thing with Lil Pump. I don't think he got locked up. His label ain't gonna let him get locked up. He drew fucking hive artists. Him and Kanye, they was on performing on SNL. Kanye went on a rant afterwards, saying that his Make America Great Again hat is a Superman cape, and he was getting bullied in the back, and they was telling him not to wear the hat. Like, Kanye, I don't think you know what bullying is. The shit you saying, degrading slavery and downplaying it, is bullying the people that were in slavery. Like, you're disrespecting them and disrespecting their family. That's bullying.
Yeah.
You can't say somebody's bullying you because they're telling you to take a hat off. They're not saying, take it off before I punch you in your face, give you a wedgie, give you a swirly, or before I degrade your brand by calling you a bigot and a stupid asshole and not letting you do your rant at the end or not letting you perform. That's not bullying. They just telling you to take it off. It'll probably be better for your image, to make you look better as a person to the community. They're trying to help you out. They're not bullying you. So cut that bullying shit off. He had some, he spoke on the 13th Amendment saying how, it's basically saying slavery is not allowed unless you're basically incarcerated. And if you're incarcerated, then you can be a legal slave. He is saying he want to abolish that. But he basically just read the amendment and came to TMZ or whatever and decided to speak about it because TMZ is a big platform. Mm-hmm. Kanye, shut up, we the fuck up.
Yeah, Conway lost. He lost it.
Kodak dropped his song, If I'm Lying, If I'm Lying, I'm Flying. I fuck with that shit, Happy. Sound like he matured from what he used to be on, but only time will tell. Quavo is announcing either his solo project, it's his Honcho Jack project. Is Honcho Jack a solo project or is it a collab album? I think it's a collab album, but
it might be a collab.
Quavo, Honcho, it might be a solo album. Alright, so Quavo working on his solo. I don't listen to the Migos like that, and I ain't even interested in listening to one of them solo. So I'm cool.
That's right.
What else? Soulja Boy supposedly bought a Subway, and like 2 days later he went there and it was closed down because the night shift didn't close the store right, so they couldn't open, and then no worker showed up in the morning, so they didn't open.
Well, that's not gonna last long.
Lil Yachty and DC Young Fly are supposed to be in How High 2 in production on that. I don't know how I feel about that. They can leave that movie alone for real.
No, yeah, that's a classic. Don't mess that up.
Yachty, he don't even smoke, so it's like, what are you even doing?
Yeah, leave that alone.
Tekashi, he dropped Stupid. That song, it's cool. We got a feature with Bobby Shmurda on it. It's highly anticipated. I can say that. The video cool. I mean, it's a Tekashi album. What more you can say? I fuck with most of his music. because of the way it sounds. Like, I can't say I don't fuck with it because I do fuck with it, but ain't really much about it.
Oh, what's up, man?
Projects dropping in October, supposedly. Lil Uzi Verse, Eternal Ataki, J.I.D., DiCaprio 2, Quavo Honcho, Thutmose, I guess, Man on Fire, Lil Baby and Gunna just dropped, Drip Harder, T.I. just dropped his album, Dime Trap, Lil Pump supposedly supposed to drop Harvard Dropout, but I don't listen to enough of his music to fucking want a project for me, so to each his own. Young Thug just dropped two projects, so I honestly really don't even think Barter 7 is going to drop him unless he's going back to Old Thug, and he dropped like he's trying to push this shit, but he got a trial coming up, so he probably won't even be trying to do too many antics for anything right now. Mm-hmm. And Lil Yachty, nothing to prove. But we'll see, because you know motherfuckers over there, like Barter 7, Thug announced that when Wayne dropped Carter 5, so it's like, he is fried trolling, but, you know, motherfuckers taking shit serious. Cardi B got some legal issues for, getting two waitresses beat up at a strip club. I thought they were strippers before, but they happen to be waitresses.
Damn,
Carter. Meek Mill, he got an album dropping. I don't know when, but he's in the studio with a lot of people. He's in the studio with J. Cole right now. That's really it. Ain't about to speak on these niggas. I ain't getting no more fucking that. Ain't really fucking, you feel me? Ain't about to get no shiny niggas. They don't need no shiny. Cause niggas just be doing shit to motherfucking get the views and shit for real. Mm-hmm. I want some shit, Soulja Boy probably didn't buy the fucking stuff, but he's probably just sitting in there eating. Or he did buy it, but motherfuckers realized that Soulja Boy bought it and quit, cause they ain't gonna work for Soulja Boy. Like, you ain't better be lying about me. You better be lying, I got this shit shot up. Dime Trap album, we got features from Yo Gotti, Young Thug. Let me go look at the whole thing. They got features from Sam Hook, Watch the Duck, Yo Gotti, Young Thug, Victoria Monet, Anderson .Paak, Meek Mill, Young Jeezy, YFN Lucci, Teyana Taylor, and London J. Let me see if we can listen to some shit. Or on YouTube. We only gonna listen to a little bit. I don't wanna get copyrighted, guys. But, this month, we should have a lot of content coming out because Black Ops 4 is releasing this month. Actually, this week coming up. So, honestly, it might be some Black Ops 4 videos playing behind this, but depending on when I drop the podcast, I might throw some Spider-Man funny moments in there. Me and Rocksteady, we both got a new Spider-Man game. We might try to get some funny moments and clips in there. But here go T.I., The Weeknd featuring Young Thug. Just for the weekend, she don't really know what's going down tonight. Up in the Kanye West, he was supposedly dropping the album. Then he quote unquote decided to push it back so he can go to Africa. And I'm tired of this nigga shenanigans. Mm-hmm. I ain't checking for Kanye West. I wasn't checking for none of the shit that came out back in fucking June and August. I listened to Nas shit, but does any of that shit got replay value? No. I ain't even listen to Drake shit all the way through. The shit I did listen to, Mob Ties, replay value. Let me go to Drake shit. ASAP shit, replay value. Survival, nonstop, emotionless, God's plan, I'm upset, God's plan, I'm upset, I already got replay value, they've been up, that's for what, been up, 8 out of 10, Mob Ties, Sandra's Rose, like, this shit got replay value, ASAP shit. ASAP Forever, Tony Tone, Praise the Lord, Buckshots, Brother Man, OG Beeper, Kids Turn Out Fine, 143rd, Black Tux, White Collar, Purity. Like, these just all got replay value. None of them Kanye shits. Let me look up Kanye. I can't spell this nigga name. The fuck is that album called? I don't even know what the album called.
That weird album he has.
The shit that just dropped. Yeah. Yay. I don't even got the songs lined up. Travis. I Thought About Killing You, no replay value. Yikes. Only probably got replay value because fucking it was by Pierre Bourne and Drake with a fucking hook. But I ain't even listen to that shit. More than once. All Mine, no replay value. Wouldn't Leave, no replay value. Ghost Town, No Mistakes, no replay value. Violent Crimes, no replay value. What's this? One of these songs. Matter of fact, All Mine is the one song I fuck with on there.
I have listened to it. I gotta be
with it. Not only fuck with it because I only fuck with it because I thought the nigga was saying la 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 la. First, like, fuck the outcome. None of us would be here with outcome. You niggas think that's a bar? Like,
that's nasty.
What the fuck?
That's nasty, man.
Hey. Any, world news? Donald Trump praising Kanye, of course.
Donald Trump's in the news every day. It was gonna move more than Barack.
On purpose.
But
they they're doing that on purpose too, because they want to get people accustomed to seeing this fat ass white dude everywhere. Nah, fuck this fat ass white dude. And they can go eat a fucking bologna sandwich. That's a fucking ass juice. But man, where can they reach you at?
Reach me at Rocksteady302, that's my PSN, or the Twitter, Teriyaki. Make sure it's 3 R's, otherwise you ain't gonna find me. That's about it. What about you, man?
You find me on PSN? Well, I got my PlayStation Plus until fucking December 5th, so I might as well stay on this account. You can find me on PSN, KeyG's13, YouTube, Body Bag Entertainment, a space between Body Bag and Entertainment. Body Bag, one word. Twitter, OG Key Gotti. And my other Twitter, I'm talking shit on most of the time, promoting my shit, ENC Body Bag. But try that new Spider-Man game. You get Black Ops 4, just know we're gonna be on there whooping niggas' asses for the free. Yeah, I might get exposed, so look for your names.
Look for your name every single time.
Bitch. We out.